the vision of India then, that it's a place where everybody, Muslims and Hindus, can be together, was what they told me, that we are like in the place and we're going to build something together in which there will be no violence, we live together in harmony, and this is Mahatma Gandhi's dream. Very aware, as Gandhiji was, that violence takes many forms, and the structures of society create violence, like for the Dalits. You don't have to be physical in your violence of them. In fact, by neglecting them, there's violence that you're causing and harm to them. Keep talking nowadays about innovation and saying, you know, the social media is an innovation and the use of digital technologies is innovation. And we run away from the problem that social technologies are causing, this innovative technology, are causing a lot of violence. And the violence they're causing is to people's beings. Because the way people are talked about, there's a positive violence caused to them. And there's a negative violence also when they're not included in a discourse, which is a real violence against the being of a person, that you don't even exist for us. You're completely outside. These experiments were done, you know, like they do most of these social sciences or behavioral science experiments, by putting these sensors onto people, onto their minds or their bodies, and seeing how the instruments show the reactions, the by the pulses that come out, the reactions. That the when these were instruments put onto the arms of people in the course of discussions in business settings, in social settings, that when a person was very sharply put down, you know, in a way, very intelligently made fun of, the reaction that the person had in the body was the same as if that person had been slapped physically very hard. The response in the body was exactly the same. So I began to then explore what are better ways of having discourse amongst people, which is non-violent, to arrive at a truth, collectively arrive at a truth. Now, this is the essence of, if you will, a democratic process. And when you reverse it and say, I have to master my art of listening to another, that's the least violence that you can cause another. Actually, allowing another, and I'm using like Gandhiji, you know, use the lathi on me, and I'm going to learn to take it and to learn something from it. So, you know, you speak, and by what you say, I will discover some elements of the objective truth. I will also discover, second thing, is why you feel so angry. I'll begin to learn about your condition. And if I can just bite my tongue and listen, I'll learn something about myself. In history, we record change being brought about violently, wars and violence. The changes that are brought about without violence, they don't make history because it's boring. And when I find young business people who say, you know, I'm fed up with, I want to give back, then I ask them, what do you most deeply care about? Now, they haven't thought of that. They just know that they're frustrated with what they're doing. And I say, but sit down and reflect. What is it you care about? And in the caring about, also start thinking about the means. Yeah, that I care for, like in these cases of the young people, they invariably say, I want not to harm anybody while we're trying to achieve success. So it's not by revolution. I want it by some evolution. So there's a principle already. Okay, but that's hard. It turns out to be hard, like you're saying. I said, that is where now you're going to take the first steps, do the innovative steps that no one else has taken. Leaders are those who do things first before others have done them, like Mahatma Gandhi did. So figure out what is it you're going to do. And when you ask me best practice, I don't know. Because I can tell you what Mahatma Gandhi did because I've read it, or what I did in my own life, but they're different circumstances. You in your look at reality, and that was something again with Mahatma Gandhi. Anyway, in strategy would teach people, just first listen to reality. And that's why I come back to listening. Until you have listened to everybody, you don't know the forces that are lurking inside, which could be negative or which could be following you. I'm saying people who wish to follow you. They would be partners in this journey. So listen, 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 and you will find you take the first steps towards what you care about. And if you've been listening, you probably already are acting towards what other people care about, because it becomes part of your being also.